Joining me now is former independent conservative presidential candidate Evan McMullin. Thanks for being here. Really good to see you again.
Great to be with you.
Do you want to respond to what Mr. Bannon had to say to the New York Times about the media?
Well, I think Mr. Bannon and Mr. Trump's attacks on the media are highly dangerous. The media, the press, plays a significant role in our democracy, and in any democracy, they're absolutely critical. And you can have disputes and disagreements over bias and even over points of fact. But to continually attack and try to erode the credibility of the media when it's doing its job, and doing its job well, I would say, in the past week especially, challenging Trump, I think is dangerous. And that's why I and my running mate from the campaign, Mindy Finn, we've established and launched a new organization called Stand Up Republic to help protect our democratic institutions, and this is part of it.
Small d, democratic.
That's right. We're conservatives, but you know what, Jake? This isn't a Republican, Democrat, conservative, liberal, progressive sort of issue. The protection, our freedom of the press, and the importance of the press in our system, the importance of the Constitution, the importance of truth, for heaven's sakes, in democracy and in our republic. Are issues that should be bipartisan or nonpartisan. These are things that we should all be able to rally around and protect as Americans. And there's the time has come, I think, in this country when we do that. And so that's what Stand Up Republic is intended to do. We're going to be working very hard to establish and grow a grassroots movement across the country that will be able to protect our fundamental ideals and our institutions.
You know, what's interesting, I have a lot of Facebook friends who are conservatives as well as liberals, and the conservatives, I've been reading a lot of their posts, and they seem very, very confused about what to believe anymore. So I think that this idea that the president and his top aides are waging war on the media is a strategy to make it clear that in their view, you can only believe one person, and that's Donald Trump, and you can't believe any of these other sources of information.
Well, that's exactly right. And this is what authoritarians or leaders with authoritarian tendencies do. It's from the playbook that they use. Donald Trump, through the past year, has said that he admires dictators and authoritarians from around the world. They attack the press because they want to undermine any other sources of information so that people start to believe that only the authoritarian can be the source of information. Because if authoritarians are able to do that, if leaders are able to undermine every other source of information, source of facts and truth, no one can hold them accountable. And their power, as a result, grows. We, as the population, start to become more divided because these leaders will tend to want to divide us and then feed us lies about each other. And we saw Donald Trump do that through the campaign, and he continues to do it until today.
You're a former CIA officer. I want to get your view on some things that the president said last night in his interview with ABC about the intelligence agency. The first is his description of his speech and his first day in office at CIA headquarters. Take a listen.
That speech was a home run. That speech, if you look at Fox, okay, I'll mention it in your network, see what Fox said. They said it was one of the great speeches. You and other networks covered it very inaccurately. I hate to say this to you, and you probably won't put it on, but turn on Fox and see how it was covered. You and a couple of other networks tried to downplay that speech, and it was very, very unfortunate that you did.
You served 10 years undercover in the CIA. Some of the stars, the 117 stars on the memorial wall behind President Trump when he spoke there, they might not be anonymous names to you, I don't know. What are your friends who are still in the agency, what is their reaction to that speech, and also just in general, President Trump's attitude towards intelligence?
Well, they're first and foremost very concerned about the national security of the country. They see a new president that wants to align our country, or he's going to align his administration with the very foreign adversary that is attacking our democracy.
Russia.
Yeah, Russia. I mean, this is unimaginable that we would have a president that would do this. And it's highly concerning, should be for all Americans, but it certainly is for them. And this is really the crux of their tension with him. It's not about personalities or anything like that. They're concerned about what he means for the national security of our country.
So they don't care about his speech. They're focused on his attitude.
They're focused on his policies and his posture vis-a-vis Putin. But,
right.
But the speech, I have to say that the symbolism of the speech was just too great to ignore. Here he is standing before a wall of stars marking the ultimate sacrifices of Americans around the world defending our interests in the worst possible conditions. And he spent most of that time talking about himself, propagating falsehoods in the process. That's who Donald Trump is. He's not somebody who has sacrificed for this country. He's somebody who attacks people who sacrificed for this country.
And what about his view that torture works? He said he was told by many intelligence leaders torture works. He also said he would defer to General Mattis and CIA Director Pompeo on the matter. But what's your experience?
Well, look, I'll say, I mean, I was never involved in the waterboarding or anything like that at the agency. That wasn't my job. I was in the field operating, carrying out operations against terrorists in the field mostly. But I will tell you that this debate about whether torture works or not, that is a debate that people have. But it misses the point. Torture is wrong. It's against the law. It's not what we should be doing, whether it works or not. And to have an American president advocating for returning to tactics that are against the law, that are classified as torture, I think is truly disappointing and alarming, among so many other things that Donald Trump does. But this is something that we as Americans need to stand up to. And I believe it's time in this country for a new era of civic engagement where we mobilize, we're better informed, we're more vigilant in defense of our democracy, in defense of our fundamental ideals. And this is part of that.
And give us the name of your group again so people at home.
Stand Up Republic. They can go to the website, standuprepublic.com, and follow us on Twitter.
Evan McMullin, always good to see you. Say hi to Mindy for us. We appreciate it.